A COVID crisis in the Victorian town of Shepparton, where more than a third of the population is tonight in isolation. As the town's outbreak climbs to 67 cases, locals are struggling to access the basics, including food. Defence Force personnel have been sent to help the community.
The MP for Shepparton, Susanna Sheed, joins us now. Susanna, this is an extraordinary, unique situation across the country, really. Can you paint us a picture of what things are like in Shepparton right now?
Well, it's just so deadly quiet, but of course there is a great deal of need out there. And in any other disasters such as floods, fire, all these things we have, the community just comes together and deals with it. There are volunteers everywhere, more people than you could ask for to help. This time around, with up to 20,000 people in isolation, there is no one to do all the work that needs to be done. You know, we're so short of people across so many areas. And I suppose it was about Tuesday that we realised day five, you know, we're good at doing things, but we actually need help.
Susanna, we're hearing reports that some people haven't eaten in days. What's being done to get the essentials to those people?
One of the biggest challenges is getting things delivered to people's houses. So a lot of it is about the logistics of getting things where they need to be rather than the lack of it. And so for many people who are, you know, financially stretched at the moment, they do need those food packages. And I'm told that a lot of them are going out all the time. But there is a need for people to move things for us. And even trucks coming in from Melbourne, they're arriving at depots in Shepparton, but there's so few truck drivers available to drive them because with so many schools closed down and all their parents out as well, it's just had a massive effect on the community.
Susanna, I know one of the problems that you've got is that there are hundreds of staff from Shepparton's hospital that are among those in isolation right now. If this outbreak gets any worse and patients need more serious attention, is the hospital actually going to be prepared?
Look, it's 460 who are currently furloughed, as they call it, and that is an incredible challenge for health. I'm worried about that. I think we're all worried about that because we know that Melbourne also has its issues, but we do have some other regional health services that have always come to our assistance. And we had an outbreak last year. So Bendigo Health were able to help us, Barwon Health. So I'm hopeful that, you know, there'll be more assistance coming there, and certainly the ADF are now on hand. So we are going to need help and we're going to need it for a while. And I'm just really hopeful now that we really are being heard and that we will get what we need.
I don't know what else to say other than good luck. It's a really, really difficult situation. Thanks so much for speaking to us.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the chance.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.